YouTube, we are back at it again. Another day, another episode. You know the vibes. Let's go. So today was a challenge. I'm not gonna lie. Today was a challenge. My goal was 30 pull-ups, you know. And last time, my first video, if you saw, go check it out. If you didn't, I did 15. You know, but the thing is, reviewing back and looking back, I know I could have done more. So today I decided to add 15 more, and I didn't want to push myself too hard because I was thinking 50, you know, but you know, you have limits, you know, your body has limits. And to be honest, these 30 took a lot out of me. You're going to see in these clips, you know, but yeah, so I did them in three. I did three pull-ups each set because that's the max I can do without feeling super drained and destroyed in a set. But yeah, I don't know the exact number of sets, but you know, I mean, it makes sense to add this up three times. I mean, to get 30, you know, and you have three sets, you're doing three each set. You know, it's obviously 10 sets. So yeah, pull-ups was the first thing on the schedule. You know, I just want to make sure that I'm getting better at these, you know, because I'm trying to be able to do 10 in a row. Right now my max is about 6, but I haven't tested it, so it's probably 5, but we'll see. You know, in a month from now I'll test them out, my max again, and to see if, you know, my pull-ups are getting better, you know. So yeah, that's the goal. But overall, man, like 30 pull-ups actually was pretty easy. No, 30 was actually easy. I mean, it was hard, but it was easier than I expected, I guess, you know. So I'll continue to do 30 until it feels like I could add probably 5 more, or maybe just another set, so 33. Or I might add just one more to the overall set and just stay like around the 30s, but we'll see, man. But yeah, okay, so boys, today we're gonna have a topic to talk about, since I don't really know what else to talk about in this video. We're gonna talk about how to run long distance, how to get started. So the best way to get started is to set a weekly mile goal. So for example, when I first started, I was doing like 12 miles a week, and I would achieve this 12 miles a week by short, you know, 2 to 3 mile runs, you know. My, like, the max that I could probably run without dying was probably like 4, maybe 5 miles, but it was around 4 miles, I remember. And it would be stupid of me to try to run that 4 miles and to try to get to that 12. So it would be stupid to just try to go out there and try to max out every time, is basically what I'm trying to say. What you want to do is you just want to slow, do like basically what I'm doing with like how I do pull-ups. You know, I'm not doing my max pull-ups that I can do in a set. So my max pull-ups is probably like 5 in a row, 6 in a row, and I'm doing half of that basically, you know. And that's basically what you want to do when you start running, you know. You want to figure out what is your true max, like how long can you run before you feel like you're about to die. Now, not like super, not like seriously about to die, but you know what I mean, you know, like where you're gassed, you know. And you want to figure that out and then just cut that in half. You could even cut it into like 1/4, to be honest, but yeah. So that's what you want to do for that, you know. And then just slowly start adding more miles, you know. But don't, like, every week don't just add a mile, you know. You want to make sure that you feel competent enough, and you know, you have that you have the ability to just to run that mile, you know. You don't want to just add it just because you've been doing it for like 2 weeks. If you're not seeing any progress, you know, then don't just add 2 miles, you know. So yeah, do that, and then, you know, slowly just keep up in the weekly mileage, you know. And eventually you'll reach a point to where You know, 12 is just easy in a single run. You know, that's where I'm at right now. You know, I literally just ran 12 miles after recording this voiceover. But, you know, and the thing is about that 12 miles too is like, before, like a couple of months ago, that the 12 miles would take a lot out of me, actually, you know. But now, you know, since I'm just so used to just running, it's pretty easy for me now. Like, I'm still gonna feel sore after this 12 miles. I already know that, you know, but I'm not gonna be out of commish for so long, you know. Like, I'm gonna be right back at it. Probably, I'll run tomorrow, to be honest, you know, but it's not gonna be 12 miles again, you know. So that's definitely something that you wanna do. So eventually you're gonna reach a point to where you could probably go on a, like a long run, you know, like an actual long run, like 10 miles plus, you know. But you're not gonna do that every week. I mean, you're not gonna do every run. I mean, you are gonna do it every week. So you have like one day where you have separate for just long run. You know, and then you have another day where you're just doing a short run. And, you know, it's just trying to do it as fast as you can, you know, like try to PR something, you know. But, yeah, that's probably the best approach. It's not anything crazy, you know. Like, I've picked it up from just YouTube videos, podcasts on just some, like, professional runners and people that have experience with running. But, yeah, it's definitely not something hard. But it's just, it's a mental game, you know.